Hey guys, for today's video, I am going to share with you all of my tips and tricks for looking good with glasses on, you know, different things that I personally like to do that I feel work really well in terms of makeup and just really helping to enhance your natural beauty. So I'm gonna take you guys through a makeup tutorial and I'm gonna start with the basics, just with the base of the face. Doing the primer and the foundation, and then we'll move on to the eyes. I'm gonna start with a very like natural makeup look to show you guys that that too looks really good with glasses. Like, you don't have to glam yourself up every single time. And then I'm gonna move on to a more everyday glam look like I'm wearing right now. If you're not familiar with glassesusa.com, they are pretty cool because they have eliminated the middleman, which means that you are able to get prescription glasses for up to 70% off retail prices, which is honestly amazing. So if you're looking for glasses, whether you need them or you just want something cute and trendy like an accessory to wear with your outfits to kind of spice things up a little bit, I would totally recommend to shop there because it's gonna be very, very affordable. You also get the prescription lenses with your frames for free to see like how these glasses are even gonna look on you before you buy them. And this is something that I personally do when I'm on the website shopping around. They have a virtual mirror and you just wanna make sure that when you upload the photo, it's like a straight on selfie. You don't wanna be tilted any which way. You just wanna straight on and it'll literally put the glasses on your face exactly the size that they are, so you can see like, okay, that's too small, it's too narrow, it's too this, too that, you know, whatever is your preference. Yeah, I love glassesusa.com and I'm excited to share with you guys all my tips and tricks. So if you'd like to see them, then just keep on watching and don't forget to leave a thumbs up for more videos like this. Subscribe if you haven't already, and yeah, hope you guys enjoy. This is the most important step right here, guys. I truly feel that you could go without any makeup, nothing on your eyes, nothing on your face, and if you just have your eyebrows done, it makes such a huge difference. It frames your face, it helps to frame out the glasses as well, and in my personal opinion, I just absolutely love shaping out my eyebrows because you can see here I have barely any hairs. I'm still in the process of growing them out. If you guys would like to see what I've been doing to help grow them out, I'll link that video above here. And then also I'm going to link above my tutorial of my updated brow routine. I do the same thing every single time. I'm just kind of briefly showing you guys here what I am doing. First, starting out with the Benefit gel, the clear brow gel, and just kind of setting my brows in place. I like to set them upwards, just force the hairs upwards, and then as I get to the outer corner, I'll kind of brush them downwards, and that way they stay exactly where I need them to be and I can see what needs filling in. I'm using this Anastasia brow pencil, and I believe this is in taupe. If not, I will definitely link down below all the products that I'm using, just in case I don't happen to have the shade name right. But I really like this pencil because it stays all day, and this shade in particular is not too dark. I have a lot of brow pencils that are almost black, like really, really dark brown. They kind of match my brow hairs, but when you fill in your brows with a shade that actually matches the darkness of your own brow hairs, they end up looking really blocky and really dark. So in order to combat that, I use a brow pencil that's a little bit lighter than my natural hairs. So here, I know this looks really weird, but I'm basically baking my brows with a yellow powder. This is from Maybelline. It's the Fit Me powder. I'm packing this onto my brows first, and with the same brush, I am then flicking off the excess product. And what this is gonna do is cool down your brow. So I'm gonna compare it and show you guys the other one that's filled in. You can see how warm that eyebrow is. This is completely, you know, personal preference, but for me, I have cool tones in my hair with the brown that is in my hair, like at the root. And so I like my brows to match the root of my hair. I don't want it to be too warm. But if you like the warm look, then you can totally skip this step. I just find that I really like the cool tones, and also it helps to really set the brow in place so it's basically waterproof. I mean, it does not budge, it does not disappear throughout the day. And then lastly, I go in with the Benefit number 5. Gimme Brow. This is so amazing for bringing the hairs back to life after you've put on your, you know, brow pencil and the powder. They just kind of start to fade away. So you want to bring them back by applying this over top, and it also adds a bit more color, but not too dark. It's got that nice cool toned taupiness to it that I love and I think matches so well with blonde hair. And I just swipe this through very carefully through the inner corner and outer corner, but I make sure to really focus on that outer corner most. So that's it for the eyebrows. Once you have them all shaped out, this next step is to curl your lashes. This is so important if you're wearing glasses, because especially if you have straight lashes naturally that grow literally straight out, they're gonna hit the frames of your glasses. It's gonna be incredibly annoying. So definitely make sure to curl them, if anything. If you're not even gonna put mascara on, that's cool, you don't have to, but just curl your lashes so they don't keep hitting your frames throughout the whole day. And then afterwards, I like to apply this Lancôme primer. This is the Definisils, and I think it works so well. It has fibers in it, so it helps to lengthen and volumize your lashes. I put that on first, let it dry for about 30 seconds, and then I work on two layers of this brand new mascara from Laura Mercier. I really, really love this. You know, my favorite used to be the Hourglass Caution Extreme Lash Mascara, and I still do really love that one and use it all the time, but this is a new favorite of mine. It gives a lot of length. And then the next step is to prep your face. This is, again, like another really important thing. I'm using the Keep Me Matte from Catrice Cosmetics. It's a brand new primer that they just came out with. And not only does it mattify your skin so that it doesn't become super oily and then your glasses slide right off your nose throughout the day, but it also makes your pores appear smaller. It reduces them, and it just gives you that nice, like, flawless airbrushed look under your foundation. I decided to also use a mattifying foundation. This is from Makeup Forever. It's called the Matte Velvet Foundation. I'm using the shade R330, which I personally feel actually matches my body really well, but unfortunately my neck, I don't know if you guys have noticed this, but my neck in this video is darker than the rest of my body because I wore a long sleeve shirt outside and played with my dog, and my freaking neck got burned. I'm like, what the heck? Now my neck is darker than everything else. But anyway, that foundation is great, incredibly long lasting, and also prevents your skin from getting too oily. And it also has full coverage as well, so it covers problem areas very nicely. I apply it with a flat top kabuki brush from Sigma, just to get the most amount, like the fullest coverage without having to use too much foundation. And for concealer, I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape in Light Neutral, just patting it into the skin under my eyes and on the sides of my nose with my fingertips. So you definitely want to stay away from caking up your face makeup too much. The more you apply, the more your glasses are going to leave an indent into your skin and, you know, create that really nasty look. You definitely want to use less makeup as you can while still getting that nice full coverage. Just, you know, apply a really thin layer of it so you don't have to worry about that issue. Here I am contouring with the Fenty Beauty Match Stick in Mocha. I really like this because it is a nice brown, not too dark, not too light, and it just creates beautiful shadows on the face. I applied it to the sides of my nose, tip of the nose, jawline, and also the cheekbones. The next step is to loosely set your makeup. So again, same thing. Do not cake it up. You want to apply the least amount of powder possible to mattify the skin, but not to look like you're wearing 1,000 pounds. So this is the brush that I like to use for this. I'll link it down below, and it just very loosely applies it where I need it, which is mostly in the T-zone area where I get the oiliest. And this will also help to really make your skin look poreless. I'm using the Laura Mercier translucent powder for that. Okay, so then you can go ahead and highlight your face. You just want to see where the sun or where the light is naturally hitting it and accentuate those parts of your face. The inner corners, on top of the cheekbones, a little bit down the bridge of the nose, tip of the nose, chin, forehead, brow bones, just anywhere that you want extra light to come in and just really bring forward. And the highlighter that I used there was from Il Maquillage. I am in love with it. It gives a really nice, soft, natural highlight instead of it looking really, you know, grainy. I hate that look. So then I applied some lip gloss to my lips after wiping away the foundation. And we are ready now for our first look. The glasses that I'm applying? What the heck? The glasses that I'm putting on here are called Otado Atrium, and they're in pink. They're so cute. Great for a natural everyday look. When you wear your glasses, you definitely want to wear them a little bit lower. Here, this is the Amelia Ebe in Barbara. I have two styles of this. So you can see right there, when you have them too high up on the bridge of your nose, like literally right next to your eyes, I just feel like it doesn't look as good because you're covering your eyebrows, you know. I like to have them just slightly downward so I can see a little bit more of my eyes and my eyebrows, and it kind of helps to make your nose appear smaller as well the lower you wear it down. Personal preference though, totally up to you guys. I just feel it looks better on me when I wear them slightly lower. So the next step is to really accentuate the eyes with creating shadows. To do this, I'm starting with a very light eyeshadow first. It's like a light brown, and I'm working this into the crease of the eye. The shadow I'm using for this is called Bucked. As you are laying this onto the eye area, you want to make sure that the majority of the product, like where you first lay it down, is on that outer corner and the very, very inner corner. Everywhere else, you just want to buff it upwards and outwards closer to that brow bone. And I used about two layers of this. I'm using the Urban Decay Naked Reloaded palette. I do love this one because the browns are more on the neutral side, so it helps to create shadows instead of creating like a super colorful look. Then I'm gonna go in after doing two layers of that with Endgame, and this one is beautiful. It's a cool toned darker brown. I'm applying this starting from the lash line, working it upwards diagonally towards the end of the brow, and then I am working it inwards into the crease. Once I feel like I don't have a lot of product left on the brush, you could either do like a smudge brush or an eyeshadow brush, something where you can just kind of pack the shade on first right where you want it, and then kind of buff out the edges into the center of the lid and also into the crease a bit. So again, I'm going to show you another time on this other eye here, starting at the center of the lash line and then working it upwards diagonally towards the end of the eyebrow. And then once I feel like I have nothing left on the brush, then I start working it inwards onto the lid and then also inwards into that crease area. By the way, I'm so sorry about my mic. I don't know what the heck is wrong with it. I think I need to restart my computer completely or something, because I keep having these like little cuts and having to redo a million times the same voiceover over and over again, but I'm just like getting fed up with it. So hopefully it doesn't bother you guys too badly. I'll definitely try and fix it for the next video. But here, I'm going in with the shade Blur from the Urban Decay Naked Reloaded palette and patting this onto the center of the lid and blending it out with my fingertip. What you want to do with this is not apply it too high. It's going to really help brighten the center and inner corner of your eyes, but also at the same time help to give the illusion of sort of like a more natural cut crease, because it's going to make that lighter brown you applied into the crease look slightly darker. So it's a more natural kind of everyday eyeshadow look. For the lower lash line, I applied the darker brown first, right along the lashes, kind of blended it out with my fingertip a bit, and then I went in with Bucked over it to kind of soften the darkness and also blended it downwards to help make the eyes appear larger. And then, for the inner corner, I applied a little bit more of my highlighter from Il Makiage just to really brighten that area up, because I feel like with all of the shadows that we applied, we kind of lost a little bit of that shimmer. So I just popped on a little bit more there. And also some mascara on the lower lashes. And for this, I'm using the Smashbox Super Fan, which I am a huge fan of and have been for a very long time. Pop Contour 101 palette, picking up that more like bronzy warm tone shade, working that on the outer corners of the face, and then just the tiniest little bit of this darker brown and working that in the hollows of the cheekbones and a little bit on the jawline and tip of the nose. I also like to go in with like a rosy red blush. This is from Il Makiage as well. And then a touch more, well, a lot more highlighter, because, you know, you can never go wrong with highlighter. Lastly, for the lips, I'm using my Koki Cosmetics lip liner in Warm Nude, and then this beautiful shade from Ofra Cosmetics. It's like a corally tone. I only apply just a touch of it in the center, and then I will blend it out with my fingertip towards the outer corners, so that way it's not too heavy of a lip, and a little bit of gloss over top. All right, last step is to set your makeup in place with the All Nighter Urban Decay Setting Spray. It really does help your makeup to last longer throughout the day, but also to actually stick better onto your skin, so that way the glasses don't pick up the makeup and take it off. I'm wearing Amelia E in Barbara Brown here. I wear these all the time, basically every single day. Every time I'm editing a video, I'm literally wearing them right now. I absolutely love them, super, super cute. But I find this everyday look also looks amazing with slightly smaller glasses as well. These are the Ataro Westons. I'm also a huge fan of these. Oh my God, they're so cute. Really stylish and definitely everyday worthy. I also wore them in the intro of the video. All right, so now we're going to make our eyes appear larger. All you have to do is get a nude liner, this one is from NYX Cosmetics, and apply it into the waterline. But you wanna make sure that you're not getting this on your lashes, you wanna just solely keep it right there in the waterline, and it'll help immediately make your eyes appear bigger than they really are. So it's a really easy, simple step that you can do with any eye makeup look. So here I'm gonna show you guys how you can elongate your eyes and make them appear longer than they really are. So for me personally, I have very small eyes that are closely set together. So what this is gonna do is just help elongate them and make it look like they're wider set apart, which really draws more attention. I happen to also draw on the thicker side because when you're doing your eyeliner, you wanna try and match it to the same size as your frames. So for example, if the glasses you're wearing, if the frames are really, really thin, then you wanna do a really thin eyeliner, or you could even do a brown eyeliner to make it more natural looking. I'm wearing more thicker frames, so I decided to do a thicker eyeliner. I usually just like to extend the line up towards the end of my eyebrow, and then from there bring it back down, and then fill in that little triangle, and then lastly kind of work it in towards that inner corner there, trying to maintain the same thickness all around. Then you can also brighten your eyes with a glitter pigment. This is brand new. It is from Siat London. I can't even believe how beautiful this is. It's so iridescent, but still kind of like not too glam, you know? It's perfect. Oh God, it is so perfect. So I just patted it on with my fingertip on the center and inner corner of the lid, but I should have totally done that first because my eyeliner got a little bit of glitter on and I had to redo it a bit, so don't make that mistake. But then you can also add more drama to your eyes by applying lashes. These are from Kiss in the style Ritzy. Very easy to apply, and I really feel like it takes your makeup look up a notch, you know, from natural to more glam. And lastly, you can throw in a fun pop of color to really spice up your look. If you happen to have glasses that are colored, then you can match your lip to your glasses. I used a lip liner from Koki Cosmetics, then an Ofra liquid lipstick, and a little bit of Wet n Wild gloss over top. I will definitely link the names down below, but it matches perfectly with my burgundy Amelia E. Barbara glasses that are like it's like a burgundy wine color. Love it. So also, if you have black glasses, you can wear like a red lip or, you know, something more neutral if you wanted to, but I do love a pop of color, especially with sunglasses. Check these babies out. These are from the Muse Hilary Duff collection in Jane. Again, definitely want to have those eyebrows to really shape out the face. You got your highlight popping, your nice soft contour, but for the sunglasses, of course, you don't have to do a dramatic eye look, so you won't even be able to see them. So what you can do instead is wear really cute cat glasses. These are Muse in Wild, which will help elongate your eyes without needing any makeup at all. I just gotta say, I love the gold trim at the top of these glasses. They're definitely gonna be my go-to for summer. Ugh, I love them.
So that's it for this video, guys. Those are all my hacks and tips and tricks that I have. If you happen to have any others that you feel like are really helpful too, definitely let us know down in the comments. And if you end up trying any of mine out, then let me know how it goes. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up if you liked this video or found it helpful. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next video. And also, don't forget to check out glassesusa.com down below in the description box.